Hi, this is Dr. Vijay. Welcome to Microsoft Word Tips and Tricks. Have you ever wished your Word document to be like this? Suppose you are working on a lengthy document like this. You used to navigate wherever you want by clicking left-hand side navigation pane. So this looks like if you are opening a soft copy of textbook. So this is called document map. So I am going to talk about document map and also another important features, table of content. So beginning of the document, you need not write the table of content. Microsoft Word will auto-generate table of content like this. You need not type each and every one and search for the page number. So today I am going to teach the two very useful features of Microsoft Word if you are working on a lengthy document. First we'll see what is document map. Here I have a Word document with different headings and subheadings. For this you should make use of Home tab, and you can see here you need to make use of these options, the styles. You can see here heading 1, heading 2, heading 3 and normal. So only you need to use this heading 1, heading 2, heading 3 and normal option under the Home tab. So you can access this document map under View tab, and you can see here under Show group there is a navigation pane. Now we will not see any heading and subheadings under this navigation pane. So if you are having older version of Microsoft Word, it will show document map under View tab. If you are updated, it will show navigation pane. So I will show how to access this document map. For this, whenever you type a heading, main heading or the section heading, just select this, go to Home tab and just click heading 1. Then imagine this is a subheading, just click that and click heading 2. So like this, you need to, when you type Word document, you should know which is main heading and which is subheading. For main or section heading, select heading 1, and for subheading, select heading 2 styles. So like this, while typing, you need to make sure which is your main section heading and which is your subsection headings. Now you can see if you click View tab and just check the box navigation pane. So you can see here it is showing under main section heading Molecules of Life. You can see if you click Carbohydrate, it will go to Carbohydrate. If you click Proteins, it will go to Proteins. Like this. Suppose you want another section. So this is the new section for me. So I will going to select this new section. Just go to Home tab and make style as heading 1. So immediately it will be displayed. So this is under Metabolism, this is subheading. So I am going to make heading 2 style. So like this, you can go anywhere in a document. If that particular document contains 1000 page, so you need not scroll like this. Just go to View tab and check the navigation pane if you are having updated version of Microsoft Word, or if you are having old version of Microsoft Word, under the View tab there is a document map. Suppose you wish to give number to this section, go to Home tab and see under paragraph group, under number bullets, just click this option. And the subheadings, a separate number, select that. Again number bullets, start with this number. So you can see here. So this is a document map, a very useful feature in Microsoft Word if you are working on a lengthy Word document. These are all random tests. So you know there is in the Microsoft Word or even Microsoft PowerPoint, you can insert random tests. If you are practicing for this, very easy. Just you need to insert equal sign, then type rand, then open bracket and close bracket. Just enter. You can see the random tests are added. Another way, just insert equal sign. You can type lorem, lorem, and open bracket and close bracket. You can insert random test. Even you can insert number of paragraph. Suppose if I insert equal sign, rand, and open bracket, and if I want to insert one paragraph, so I will click one here and close the bracket, enter. So one paragraph going to be inserted. So this is inserting random text into your document. So if you are practicing, you can make use of these features. So this document map is a very useful feature if you are working on a lengthy Word document where you can navigate like this. So wherever you want, it will take you to that particular sections and subsections. Now I will talk about table of content. You can see here, so I have not typed this table of content. It is auto-generated. So how to make use of these features? I will show now. So here in this particular document, I need to insert table of content in this particular page. For this, you need to go to reference, under reference tab. So you can see in the beginning there is a table of content. You click that drop down menu. There are different styles. I am going to click this. So you can see it will generate, if you have given the number for the subsection, it will show numbers, main title, subtitle and page number. So it will generate table of content. So now I will give for this metabolism the separate section number now. Go to home, here just you click this one. So you can see here. Now if you make any changes in the document, this table of content will not update automatically. So here you need to click this table of content. You can see here clearly there is update table option. Just click update. It will ask update page number only or update entire table. So you check update entire table, click OK. You see number will be there in your table of content. So this will increase efficiency and save lot of time when you working on a lengthy document. If you haven't subscribed, please subscribe and click the bell button for future notification. Thanks for watching.